الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، we're going to take لا إله إلا الله. Today we're going to study لا إله إلا الله. What does لا إله إلا الله mean? Number two, what is the pillars of لا إله إلا الله? Number three, what are the conditions of لا إله إلا الله? We're going to take those three. Meaning of لا إله إلا الله, pillars of لا إله إلا الله, and the شروط, the conditions of لا إله إلا الله. Those are the three main points that we're going to take today in our class, inshallah ta'ala. لا إله إلا الله, what does it mean? معنى هذه الكلمة لا إله إلا الله, أي لا معبود بحق إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله, what does it mean? لا معبود, there is nothing that is worshipped بحق, deserving, who has the right to be worshipped other than Allah عز وجل, بحق إلا الله. Pay attention here. There are other things that are worshipped other than Allah, but are they deserving? No, they're not. Bihaqqin is what we bring here. There are other ilah that are worshipped, but those ilah that are worshipped, they don't have no rights. They don't have any rights to be what? To be worshipped. The only one that has rights to be worshipped is who? Allahu Azza wa Jalla is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. That's why we say, ay, la ma'buda, there is none worthy of worship, bihaqqin illa Allah, except Allah Azza wa Jalla. He is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. Here's the question now. We use the word what? Ma'bud, which is taken from the word what? Ibadah. Ma'bud is the one that's worshipped. Ibadah is the action itself. Sah? Then the question is, what is ibadah? If you're saying that ibadah can only be done for Allah, and he's the only one who deserves it, then the important question that we need to ask ourselves is, what is ibadah? What are its conditions for someone's ibadah to be accepted? What are its conditions? What does ibadah actually mean? I defined it here for you. Ibadah is a ismun jami', a general term. لِكُلِّ مَا يُحِبُّ اللَّهُ وَيَرْضَاهُ, everything which Allah loves and is pleased with. That which Allah loves and is pleased with can be from what? So remember, pay attention. Ibadah is what? Everything Allah loves and is okay. Allah loves it and he's pleased with it. This is ibadah, right? Ibadah can occur from how many places? Two places. It can be al-aqwal, speeches, and it can be a'mal. Meaning Allah loves and he's pleased with a speech. Or Allah loves and he's pleased with an action. The question here is, and we're going to come to that later, how does one know Allah loves something and he's pleased with it? The only way you can know is through who? It's through the Quran. Allah has to tell you, I love this. Okay? Allah has to tell you, I am pleased with this. And the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. He's the only one who can tell us what Allah loves and Allah is pleased with. There's no other way to know. So if someone does an ibadah, he does an act, and then he says Allah loves this and he's pleased with it, and he didn't get it from the Quran, and he didn't get it from the Sunnah, he's lying. He's actually lying. What? He's lying. Because how do you know Allah loves this and he's pleased with it? You wouldn't know. Now, the speech can come from where? Internally. There's an internal speech and there's an external speech. Are we all together? So there's speech which you say with your mouth and there's a speech which you say with your heart. Okay? And there's actions which happen from the mouth. Sorry, from the limbs, from your body parts, your limbs, and it also happens from what? Internally. An example of speech that comes from the mouth is La ilaha illallah, dhikr, all of them are speeches that come from the mouth. Speech that comes from within is like al-iqrar, affirming Allah Azza wa Jalla. Affirmation. Iqrar is what? It's the speech of the heart. What about the actions? Two types. External, internal and external. Inside, actions inside, actions outside. What is an example of actions which are inside? Al-khawf wal-raja wal-raghba wal-rahba wal-inaba wal-tawakkul. All of those are actions which are inside. What about actions which are outside? As-salah, as-zakah, as-sawm, al-hajj. Are we all together? All of those are what? Actions which are? All of those, Allah has to be pleased with it, and Allah has to love this thing. If it occurs from the tongue and Allah doesn't love it or not pleased with it, it's not ibadah. Okay? Pay attention. Or if it occurs from the heart and Allah doesn't love it nor is He pleased with it, it's not ibadah. Or if it occurs from the limbs and Allah doesn't love it or is not pleased with it, it's not ibadah. Okay? There is no other way to determine ibadah except Allah loves it and is pleased with it. And ibadah can occur from those places. So from the aqwal is two types, and from the a'mal is what? It's two types. Okay? وَهِيَ تَنْبَنِي عَلَى ثَلَاثَةِ أَرْكَانِ. Ibadah is built on how many pillars? We're not talking about La ilaha illallah, we're talking about what? Ibadah. Reason why we went into ibadah is because that word is mentioned in the definition of La ilaha illallah. Ibadah is built upon three pillars. Three pillars. كَمَالُ الْحُبِّ لِلْمَعْبُودِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. That Allah Azza wa Jalla, you completely love Him. You what? You completely love Him. In your heart, there is complete love for Allah. As Allah said in the ayah, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبَّا لِلَّهِ. The believers, they excessively love, أَشَدْ. Excessively they love Allah Azza wa Jalla. Not partially, not half-heartedly. They completely love Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and absolutely love Him. The second pillar in which ibadah comes with and it requires is kamalur raja. You completely hope in Allah Azza wa Jalla. You have complete hope in Allah Azza wa Jalla. As Allah said, وَيَرْجُونَ رَحْمَتَهُ. They hope for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's mercy. And number three is kamalul khawf. Complete fear. You completely fear Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah said, وَيَخَافُونَ عَذَابَهُ. وَيَخَافُونَ عَذَابَهُ. And they fear His punishment subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, pay attention to this. These three pillars, they get rid of deviated groups. Like for example, the Sufis. The Sufiya, they just believe Allah should be worshipped only on love. We should only love Him. That's it. And they don't come with the other two. Okay, or more like they don't come with the third one. They don't want to fear Allah Azza wa Jalla. They say, why should I be scared of Him? I worship Allah upon love. Yeah, so they're misguided. They are misguided in that statement. The second group of people are the murji'ah, a deviated group, who only worship Allah upon ar-raja, hope. They are a deviated group. They say, if you come with iman, any sin that you do will not harm your iman. And today you hear them come in different forms. My iman is in my heart. How do you know what's in my heart? How do you know what's in my qalb? You see, or those who say, just focus on what's in your heart. Forget what's on your apparent, your limbs. It's another statement of irja, where a person says, just focus on your heart. Forget your outer appearance and the way you look externally. Like what's in your heart shouldn't show on your limbs, it should. Are we all together? If your heart is good, it will show on your limbs. It will what? It will show on your limbs. Number three, kamalul khawf, complete fear. The ones who worship Allah on complete fear are a deviated group, which is the Khawarij, modern day ISIS. They worship on fear. Every time they're talking about ayat which are khawf, fear, ahadith which are fear. بَلَا مَنْ كَسَبَ سَيِّئَةً وَأَحَاطَتْ بِهِ خَطِيئَةٌ فَأُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. They leave the verses that bring hope. They get rid of those verses. They don't look at it. They only look at ayatul khawf, ahadithul khawf. That's all they focus on. Ahlus sunnah, the people of the sunnah, they take all three. They take what? All three. They worship Allah upon love, upon hope, and upon fear. That's how they are. Like a bird, it has two wings and a head. Those are the three. Without those three, a bird can't go anywhere, can it? Ahlus Sunnah, they're like that bird. Where are they flying to? Allah Azza wa Jalla. Will they get there? Of course they will, because they have what it takes to get to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Okay, now we're gonna go back to La ilaha illallah. What are its condition of acceptance? And I'm going to go back to La ilaha illallah. What are the conditions of ibadah being accepted? We learned the pillars of ibadah, right? But we haven't learned the conditions. Pay attention here. Everyone focus here, please. I want you to all focus. Ibadah is not accepted. A person's ibadah is not accepted unless he meets these two criterias. Unless he meets these two conditions. A person's ibadah is not, is rejected, is mardood. What are they? The first one is al-ikhlasu fiha lil-ma'bud. That you do sincerity for Allah Azza wa Jalla. You do it only for His sake, subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one else's sake. When you are praying Salatul Taraweeh, when you are praying Fajr, when you are fasting, everything you do, every ibadah that you do, who are you doing it for? Allahu Azza wa Jalla. No one else. No one else is in your heart. Ikhlasuna lillahi saffil qalba min iradatin siwahu fahdhar ya fatin. Who are you doing it for? Allah alone. No one else. In your heart is Allah. You're only thinking and hoping reward from Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's ikhlas. Okay? And there are many ayats in the Quran. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ قُلْ إِنِّي أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ وَأُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ. These are verses which mean, pay attention here, ikhlas. This is only for Allah. وَلِذَلِكَ the hadith al-Qudsi is أَنَا أَغْنَى الشُّرَكَاءِ عَنِ الشِّرْكِ مَنْ أَشْرَكَ فِيهِ مَعِي غَيْرِ تَرَكْتُهُ وَشِرْكَهُ. Ikhlas. Allah is saying, أَنَا أَغْنَى الشُّرَكَى. I am rich. I am in no need of the creation. Then the Messenger said, Allah said, مَنْ أَشْرَكَ مَعِي. Anyone who associates partners with me in ibadah, anyone who associates partners with me, تَرَكْتُهُ, I leave him. وَشِرْكَ, and I leave that which he associated me with. Rejection. It's not accepted. Allah won't accept it. He will reject it. The second one is al-mutaba'ah. Al-mutaba'ah to lil-rasool sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To who? The Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. The second condition of ibadah is that you follow the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Everything in ibadah that you do, you ask yourself, did the Messenger do this or not? If you don't have the Prophet who preceded you in this, it is rejected. It is not accepted. It is not accepted. There are many ayat. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهِ فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَن يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. So those are the two conditions. For any ibadah to be accepted, it has to be only done for Allah's sake, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it has to be done in the way that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did it. Now we're going to go into shurutu sihhatu shahadatain. Shahadu an la ilaha illallah. وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. For it to be correct, for it to be accepted, there are 7 conditions that have to be met. And these are the 7 conditions. And Al-Imam Hafiz, Al-Imam Al-Hafiz Al-Hakami rahimahullah, he made a poetry out of it. He said, Al-ilmu wal-yaqinu wal-qabulu wal-inqiyadu fadri ma aqulu wa sidqu wal-ikhlasu wal-mahabba wafaqakallahu lima ahabba. Those are the 7. If you can't remember it, just remember the poetry. Al-ilmu wal-yaqinu wal-qabulu wal-inqiyadu fadri ma aqulu wa sidqu wal-ikhlasu wal-mahabba wafaqakallahu lima ahabba. Those are the 7 conditions of La ilaha illallah. What are they? The 7 conditions of what? Of La ilaha illallah. If you don't come with these 7 conditions, your La ilaha illallah is not correct. It is null and void. What is the first one? Al-ilmu, knowledge. Al-yaqeenu, certainty. Al-qabulu, acceptance. Al-inqiyadu, submission. Al-sidqu, truthfulness and believing. 7, al-ikhlasu, sincerity. And number 7, al-mahabbah, love. All of them, they have evidences. Al-ilmu, what's the evidence for it? فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَاسْتَغْفِرْ لِذَنْبِكَ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ. What surah is it in? The rest is homework. I want every one of you to bring me the evidences for the other remaining 6. Next week, Tuesday, the homework is you have to bring me dalil. Dalil is from where? Al-Qur'anu was-sunnah. Either from the Qur'an or the sunnah, you're going to have to bring me evidence for the other 6. The other 6, dalil. You're going to say, what dalilu qawluhu ta'ala, what dalilu qawluhu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, evidence. For this one, 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 for this one. No, no, just if you bring one ayah or one hadith is enough. Are we all together? And I want everybody to memorize that line of poetry. Al-ilmu wal-yaqinu wal-qabulu wal-inqiyadu fadri ma aqulu wa sidqu wal-ikhlasu wal-mahabba wafaqakallahu lima ahabba. I want everybody to memorize that, okay? And we're going to conclude there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka atubu ilayh.